Howdy, my amigos. Today we are going to be discussing the top 10 worst movies of the year. Originally, I had planned to do the top 10 best movies of the year before this, but there are a few things on the list that I'm still yet to see. But there are still a few movies that I think will make the list that I haven't seen yet. The worst movies, on the other hand, I'm pretty sure I've seen everything I've needed to see, to be honest. I kind of think that the worst of the year list is more exciting than the best of the year list. I am just a complete sucker for bad movies. I love them. Sometimes I even like them more than good movies. Especially when you're watching Hollywood trash that is just laughably bad, that shit can be good. But without further ado, let's get onto the top 10 list, right? Number 10. Cheaper by the Dozen.
Alright, that's it. None of you girls are ever dating.
That's sexist.
This is one of the many announced remakes Disney announced for Disney Plus. This includes the new Wimpy Kid films and Home Sweet Home Alone, which were released last year. All of these movies were released on the platform and then instantly forgotten about. Cheaper by the Dozen from 2022, I think, is the second remake of the original film. This one and the Steve Martin one seem to be made to be more modernized for a younger audience watching it. In this case, one of the kids is like a tech genius and the other one is like a TikTok influencer. It's one of those movies that tries way too hard to appeal to its audience that it ends up being very unmemorable.
Oh, thank you. It's Balenciaga.
There are just way too many characters in this movie that you're meant to connect with, and that's one of the very major issues with this movie. None of these characters have anything to do. Also, having about 7 child actors occupy a scene is just a recipe for disaster.
So I thought we should celebrate. How about some Flamin' Hot Cheetos and Ciroc?
Number 9. Secret Headquarters.
I can't be near Skullcutters!
Owen Wilson plays a knockoff Iron Man in this very cheap Paramount movie that was made for their streaming service. And surprise, surprise, it's another movie filled with very bad child actors. They're all meant to be about 14 years old, but the main kid looks like he's about 10, his best friend looks like he's about 16, and the other two characters look like they're about 12. The main kid discovers that his dad is actually a superhero once him and his friends discover his underground lab. I understand that this is meant to be a movie for kids, but the logic in this movie just makes no sense at all. The MacGuffin in this movie is this power source that allows his dad to be a superhero, and apparently it can just kinda do anything. There is no setup about when his suit runs out of power. They do not explain how the source built his entire lab. They just sort of have the characters say, "Oh yeah, the power source did it." Would it also surprise you if Owen Wilson was barely in this movie? He just leaves midway through the first act and then returns midway into the final act, even though they plaster him all over the marketing. This is meant to be a superhero movie made for very young teenagers, but do you really think they want to see this?
And how do you plan on torturing me? Are you gonna tickle torture me?
Kids can still go see Marvel movies if they please. It's not like those are super gory films or anything. And Paramount expects this to be on the same sort of rank. If I was a kid, I would have picked to see anything by Marvel over this.
You want to dance with the King of Pop?
Number 8. Don't Worry, Darling. People really buzzed about this movie before it even came out. I tried to watch Olivia Wilde's other movie, Booksmart. The whole thing was just so cringy, I could barely get through it. Don't Worry, Darling is just straight up an Oscar bait movie, with Amsterdam from this year also sharing that title. It's going for Best Picture, Best Actor, Best Actress, Best Screenplay, Best Directing, Best Score, Best Production Design, Best Costumes, Best Makeup and Hairstyling, Best Editing, and Best Cinematography. So about any Oscar that a feature-length film can get. I didn't let any of the behind-the-scenes drama ruin my experience of the film, but you can really tell that Florence Pugh is just not getting enough direction from Olivia Wilde. This movie has no significant messaging, even though it's pretending that something's going on. I don't want to spoil the movie, and I won't, but the way that the movie leads up to the conclusion is extremely frustrating and just doesn't make any sense at all. Also, whose idea was it to put Harry Styles in a leading role? The end result of that was awful.
I gave you all of this, Alice! We are lucky to be here!
Number 7, Jurassic World Dominion. What the fuck? You couldn't even try to make a good movie? I don't even know what I can say about this movie that hasn't been said already. The first Jurassic World movie proved that this trilogy could be somewhat promising. But now, after seeing Fallen Kingdom and Dominion, I'm lost for words. There are a million plots going on in this movie. There was this whole plot about cloning, and that was just laughably bad. Then you have this plot about these big bugs, which I don't think actually had much to do with the actual film. And then you have the newer generation of characters trying to save a baby dinosaur, which was only thrown in there so they could link up with the older generation of actors. The funniest part is, nobody in this movie looks like that they want to be there. Everybody working on this movie knew that this was going to be a piece of shit, and somehow it still grossed over $1 billion. Number 6, Samaritan. Sylvester Stallone has been trying to get back into the game for over 30 years now. If it means making a new Rambo movie, he'll do it. If it means being in some weird low-budget Prison Break movie, he'll do it. His latest venture of Samaritan shows him doing superhero stuff. Somehow, this movie had a budget of $100 million. Where did that money go? I was estimating a good $10 million, but holy shit. This movie looks cheap as hell. I swear, there were only about 5 different locations this entire movie. It's the most generic cookie cutter movie on this list. It's all just so boring. The movie was helmed by Amazon, and it shares that very cheap look that all of their movies have. I haven't seen much by Amazon that I'm yet to actually enjoy, unless it's Spencer, because that's the only movie that they clearly cared about.
You're a liar! I don't believe you!
This ain't shit.
Number 5, Uncharted.
I'm like literally in a Papa John's right now.
I know I've talked about this movie before, but oh my god, is it just so dull. For someone who hasn't even played the games, even I was let down. There is just such a miscasting in this movie. Tom Holland and Mark Wahlberg are just not right for these roles. One thing that I didn't really touch up on in my review was just how bad the visual effects and the set designs were. They are just not up to standard with what is coming out nowadays. It makes everything look incredibly fake and unbelievable. In my review, I also didn't talk about Sony as a studio enough. We'll talk about that soon on another very obvious movie on this list. If you want to know more about my thoughts, definitely go check out my other video. Number 4, Minions, The Rise of Gru. I fucking hate Minions. Do I really have to say more? I didn't dress up in a suit to go see this movie because I'm not a douchebag, but I went to go see this with a group of friends because we thought it would be funny. But my god, it wasn't so funny when I was trapped in a movie theater for nearly 90 minutes with nothing else to do but watch the burning depths of hell. I will compliment the movie though and say that it was slightly better than the first one. At least this one has a plot, but most of that just kind of fizzles out after the first act. And then all we get after that is just minions doing karate and minions fly a plane. This is definitely the most brain dead and substanceless movie of the year. Number 3. Morbius. This is the movie that made me put my hand on Sony's shoulder and say, hey buddy, it's time to give it up. But now after 5 bad Spider-Man related movies and 1 good one, we're still getting 3 more movies about characters that we've never heard of. Morbius will probably stay at the top of the list. It's the most baffling movie Sony has ever made. How did any of this shit even get past the studio to the point where they thought it was polished enough for release? I know that Jared Leto was being hard to work with, but the movie still looks bad. Morbius was giving me flashbacks to other movies like Ghost Rider and Daredevil. It's on that same level of unintentional corniness. Scrap that. I wouldn't even say that. This movie is far worse than those ones. It tries way too hard to be on the same level as other Marvel movies in the MCU. It even tries to set up more in the Marvel / Sony universe. Even though this movie had some very clear design flaws, holy shit do I want to see it again. It's one of those so bad that it's just so good movies. I really want to talk about this movie more in more detail, but that's kind of like beating a dead horse. So I'm just gonna leave it. I would weirdly recommend it though. Number 2, Pinocchio, the Disney one.
Cricket's the name, Jiminy Cricket, be precise.
Just like Uncharted, I've talked about this movie before too. If I could take anything back from that review, it would be that I was being too nice to the other Disney remakes. I think that Pinocchio is the worst one of the bunch, but in no way is The Lion King from 2019 a good movie. There are 2 reasons why you would want to remake a movie. The first reason would be to add more in order to improve the original film. And the other reason would be strictly money. But this movie was released on Disney Plus, so the question is, why bother making this at all? Especially if it's very likely to get a negative response, which it did. Somehow they managed to extend this film by 17 minutes, even though all they do is take away from the original movie. And all they did was add this female Puppet Master character who contributes nothing to the actual film.
No!
Alright, here we go. Here's the worst movie of the year. Drumroll please. And the worst movie of 2022 is The Bubble.
Looks like we're about to have us a hoedown.
Alright, here we go.
Okay, get out of line. Okay, it's going down. Okay, you know my temper is way shorter than the fine. Okay, we not the same, no mama. I don't wait in line. Okay, you say you wish it like a fussy.
I must kill them all.
This is the worst movie of the year. I would even confidently say this is the worst movie of the last few years. I would honestly love to do an entire video dedicated to this movie because it is honestly so tragic. The movie is about some actors trying to make a sequel to a franchise film during the COVID-19 pandemic. Antics ensue! The movie was helmed by Judd Apatow, and I didn't even realize it was made by him at first. It still has his style of very bland filmmaking, 3-point lighting, and over-the-shoulder shots all the time. Very generic music. This movie stars actors from the bottom of the A-list, and then also Pedro Pascal. He's probably only in this movie because he owed the director a favor. The entire movie is about rich actors complaining and whining over how they have to follow the COVID-19 rules while staying in a mega mansion. And the movie expects you to care for them. I did the same shit, and I wasn't in a mansion with servants to cater to my every need. What they have going on looks like fun. Judd Apatow is just such a hack. This man has never made a good movie in his entire life. Oh, but what about the 40-year-old virgin and Superbad? Are you 12? This is the bare bones bottom of his terrible film career. How do any of his movies even get funded? Each character is trying to be like a different kind of movie actor. You have the Academy Award winner, you have the action star, you have the comedian, you have the influencer, you have Wait, what the fuck? Name one movie that stars a TikTok influencer just so it can generate money. I swear to God, this movie has about 5 scenes where the actors just start making TikToks and dancing because I guess that's funny. And then all the real actors start talking about how much fun they had making this movie. And yeah, it probably was fun, but it's getting in the way of the movie actually being quality. My favorite part of the movie was when they started to film outside an actual film studio, and it looks like a 10-year-old making ninjas versus Spider-Man on iMovie. This movie is over 2 hours long, and it's honestly about nothing. What a waste of time. Alright, there we go. Those were the 10 worst movies of 2022. I did really want to get the top 10 best movies list out first, but I still have to watch The Fabelmans. I'm going to have to exclude Babylon and The Whale because in New Zealand I just won't be able to watch them in time. Anyway, I really hope you enjoyed the video. The only movie on this list I would recommend is Morbius. I guess the only thing we can take away from these movies is that child actors and TikTok are becoming quite a big thing in the film industry. Low budget superhero movies are also becoming a thing and they're awful. But this was actually quite a good year for movies, and I really can't wait to share the top 10 best movies of the year with you. Let's go full on watch Mojo style. Let's give some honorable mentions to things that didn't quite make the list. If She-Hulk met the guidelines to be on this list, it definitely would have been. But then the other bad movies of the year consist of Super Pets with Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart, The Lost City with Sandra Bullock and Channing Tatum, and then also Black Adam, which I wish I could call the worst movie of the year. But if I'm being subjective, it only just missed being in the top 10 worst movies of the year. Just remember that all of this is just my opinion. I don't speak for everyone. But anyway, let's just wrap it up here. Have a good night, everyone.